بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحابته أجمعين أما بعد رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي Alhamdulillah, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are still in the book of Al-Imam al-Nawawi, the 40 hadith of Al-Imam al-Nawawi. We are on the hadith number 10. Al-halalu al-tayyibu shartul qabuli. Eating that which is beautiful, that is halal, is one of the conditions for the a'mal to be accepted and the dua to be answered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. An Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم on the authority of Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه may Allah be pleased with him who said the messenger of Allah سبحانه وتعالى said إن الله طيب لا يقبل إلا طيبا Allah the Almighty is good and accept only that which is good Inshallah, I'll come to explain each bit, inshallah. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ أَمَرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ بِمَا أَمَرَ بِهِ الْمُرْسَلِينَ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded the faithful to do that which He commanded the messengers. فَقَالَ تَعَالَى يَا أَيُّهَا الرُّسُلُ كُلُوا مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ وَاعْمَلُوا صَالِحًا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, O the messengers, eat of the good things and do right. Eat that which is good and do the good deeds. And then in the Surah Al-Mu'minun, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu kulu min tayyibati ma razaqnakum. In Surah Al-Baqarah, Ayah 172, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, O who you believe, eat of the good thing that we have provided for you. And then, ثُمَّ ذَكَرَ The hadith continues, ثُمَّ ذَكَرَ الرَّجُلُ يُطِيلُ السَّفَرَ Then he mentioned the case of a man who having a long journey, and أَشْعَثَ أَغْبَرَ The hair is so messy, disheveled, and أغبرَ dusted, full of dust. يَمُدُّ يَدَيْهِ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ And then who spreads out his hands to the sky, saying, what does he say? يَا رَبِّي, يَا رَبِّي. He says, Oh Lord, Oh Lord. وَمَطْعَمُهُ حَرَامٌ وَمَشْرَبُهُ حَرَامٌ وَمَلْبَسُهُ حَرَامٌ While his food is unlawful, he's calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, while his food that is eating is unlawful, and his drink is unlawful, and his clothing also is unlawful. وَغُدِيَ بِالْحَرَامِ He is nourished unlawfully. He is fed unlawfully. فَأَنَّا يُسْتَجَابُ لِذَلِكَ The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, so how can he be answered? The hadith is related by Imam Muslim. Inshallah, let's go into deeper explanation of the hadith so that we can understand. The hadith is narrated, is on the authority of Abu Huraira. We've explained who Abu Huraira is. He's one of the great Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, The Prophet ﷺ is saying, إِنَّ اللَّهَ طَيِّبٌ لَا يَقْبَلُ إِلَّا طَيِّبًا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is good and accept nothing except that which is good. So when you are giving something, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expect you to give the best. Something that you have earned with your hard work, instead of giving in charity or whichever way, that which is haram. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not interested in something that is haram, and He will not reward you if you're giving charity or whatever from the money that is haram. For example, if you want to pray, you could not use water that has urine to perform your wudu, to go and perform your salah. Therefore, you could not use money that is full of filth inside, the money of which involves a lot of lying, a lot of cheating, to go and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using that money. Therefore the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he's saying, "Inna Allah tayyibun la yaqbalu illa tayyiba." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts only that which is good. And also, "Inna Allah amara al-mu'minina bima amara bihi al-mursaleen." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the commandment that is given the believers, it is the same commandment that is given to the prophets. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given the orders to the prophets to eat that which is good and also follow it with good a'mals, then the a'mals will be accepted. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Ya ayyuhar rusulu," he's calling on the prophets, "kulu min at-tayyibati," eat that which is good, the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you with, which are good, which are halal. وَعْمَلُوا صَالِحًا. After that, once you've got energy from eating that which is haram, the body has energy, then use the body to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do which is that which is righteous deed. And then he said, وَقَالَ تَعَالَى, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُلُوا مِن طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. He's showing in the first ayah in Surah Al-Mu'minun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered the prophets to eat that is good and follow it with good a'mal. And then now he's ordering the normal believers, that he's saying, "Oh, who you believe, كُلُوا مِن طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. Eat from the goodness, the good, that which we have provided for you." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the provider. Therefore, eat that which is halal. Take care of eating that which is halal and avoid that which is haram, which includes cheating, which includes deceiving people, and which includes with lies and everything. It will only increase your level of sins. It will not increase your rizq. Inshallah, let's go into a little bit deeper explanation with regard to this hadith, so that we can understand the hadith itself and then benefit from this great hadith. We will explain what we learn from this hadith and the benefits. So to start with, we are just reading the Arabics and explaining it into English. Now let's go into deeper understanding of what it means to our life. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet ﷺ is saying in the hadith, "Inna Allah tayyibun." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, tahirun, mutanazzahun anin naqa'is wal uyub. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is complete. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have no defect. He's complete, absolute complete. You could not find any fault in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La yaqbalu illa tayyiban. أي لا يقبل من الأعمال إلا ما كان خالصا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept not of the good deeds or any deeds that ones do, except that which is done with sincerity, that is done to earn the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not that which is done to show off people. Any a'mal that include the showing off, then it will not be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he's saying, وَلَا يَقْبَلُ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ إِلَّا مَا كَانَ حَلَالًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept any giving that we've given in charity, or anyhow that we've given, except that which is halal. You could not go and gamble and then take that money to build the mosque. You could not go and cheat people and then use that money to pay charity. You could not go and steal the money and then go and contribute in good causes. You could not that because you couldn't do that because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will not accept your deeds. The example that I've given, if you have dirty water that has najis, you could not use it to perform ghusl, or you couldn't use it to perform your wudu, so that you can perform your salat. So it is exactly the same. If you have money that which is full of debt, which has been earned in the wrong way, therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is not interested and he will not reward you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet ﷺ said, أَمَرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ بِمَا أَمَرَ بِهِ الْمُرْسَلِينَ سَوَاءً بَيْنَهُمْ. All of them are the same. فِي الْخِطَابِ وِوُجُوبِ أَكْلِ الْحَلَالِ. the way the prophets were ordered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to eat that which is halal, that which is good, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided for them, and avoid that which has cheating and deceiving and stealing and all that. The way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered the prophets, He's ordered the believers also to follow the footsteps of the Prophet and eat that which is halal. And we have explained with the ayahs that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said. Now he said, ثُمَّ ذَكَرَ الرَّجُلُ يُطِيلُ السَّفَرُ. Then he's mentioning the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, of a man who's been involved in a very long journey. أَشْعَثَ أَغْبَرَ. Ash'atha is somebody with large hair and which is not been taken care of. Aghbara, then the hair itself is full of dust. The explanation of the hadith of Aghbara, he said, غَيَّرَ الْغُبَارُ لَوْنَ شَعْرِهِ. The dust has changed the color of the hair, with the hair being so much large amount and so much dust with which he is involved in his journey, in this journey, with which he had a large hair, which is full of dust, and the journey was a journey of ta'a, for example, like hajj or jihad. But then that person, he said, the Prophet ﷺ, يَمُدُّ يَدَيْهِ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ. He raises up his hands, يَرْفَعُ يَدَيْهِ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ, إِلَى السَّمَاءِ, دَاعِيًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's asking Allah, Ya Rabbi, Ya Rabbi, Ya Allah, Oh Lord, Oh Lord. This person, and then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, now these are the reasons why his dua will not be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, of this person who's saying, Ya Rabbi, Ya Rabbi, Ya Rabbi, wa mat'amuhu haramun, that which is eating is haram. The earning of haram. Therefore, if you are eating that which is haram, know that your a'mals will not be accepted and your dua also will not be accepted. This is the teaching from this hadith. وَمَشْرَبُهُ حَرَامٌ. That which is drinking is also unlawful, is haram. وَمَلْبَسُهُ حَرَامٌ. The clothes that you are wearing, it is unlawfully obtained. For example, if you've taken a Visa card or something, you've gone and stolen somebody else's money and you've bought a cloth, you couldn't use that cloth to come and pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will not be rewarded, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not interested in that which you have stolen or which you have cheated others to come and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using that kind of thing. So if you are to make using those things in you, and you are to make the dua, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet ﷺ said, وَغُدِيَ بِالْحَرَامِ, and this person is nourished and is brought up and is eating and is surrounded by that which is haram and lawful. Therefore, the Prophet ﷺ, he's saying, فَأَنَّا يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُ, أي كَيْفَ وَأَيْنَ يُسْتَجَابُ لِمَنْ كَانَتْ هَذِهِ صِفَتُهُ. If someone has these characteristics, he is stealing money, his food is haram, his drink is haram, his clothes is haram, whatever that he's been brought up with is haram, therefore, how will this person be expecting for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be accepting his dua? It doesn't matter, no matter if he's in a journey, and also if he's the hair is dust, doing a journey of hajj or something, if the money is through cheating and all this, therefore he will not be amongst those people who will be prioritized to be answered, the dua to be answered. So what do we benefit from this great hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Anna min asma'i Allahi at-tayyiba. Inna Allaha tayyibun is one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ma'nahu al-mutanazzihu anin naqaisi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is full and complete, and there's no any defects or any faults in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, what do we benefit from this great hadith? Al-amru bi-ikhlas al-amali lillahi ta'ala. And we are told that, we've been ordered, the a'mals that we do, we should do it to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with sincerity. to do it with sincerity. وَأَنَّ عَلَى الْمُسْلِمِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ بِالطَّيِّبِ مِنَ الْأَعْمَالِ وَالْمَكَاسِبِ. A mu'min, a believer, should come or should bring forward to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the a'mals that he's doing, and the earnings that he's earning should be that which is halal and accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, what do we learn from this hadith? أَنَّ الصَّدَقَةَ لَا تُقْبَلُ إِلَّا مِنْ مَالٍ حَلَالٍ. The charity will not be accepted except from the money that was earned in the halal way. If you have cheated, if you have stolen, if you've involved lies to obtain that money, therefore it will not be accepted. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in another hadith, he said, لَا تُقْبَلُ صَلَاةٌ بِغَيْرِ طَهُورٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't accept salat without tahara. If you're not clean from any of the impurities, minor and major impurities, najis, ghusl, therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept your amal. Therefore you have to clean yourself. Islam is about cleanliness. وَلَا صَدَقَةٌ مِنْ غُلُولٍ. And the Prophet ﷺ said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not reward the charity that has been obtained from cheating and in deceiving manners. Therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not reward that kind of charities. And also, one of the things that we can benefit, anna akl al-haram min asbab adam qubul al-du'a. One of the things that stops the dua being accepted is eating that which is unlawful. If you eat or drink that which is unlawful, or you wear that which is unlawful, it can be the means of your dua not being accepted. Therefore, if you are making dua now and you're making dua again and again and again, and you do not see sometimes that is to be accepted, therefore sometimes the reason could be to assess yourself and look at your food, look at your drinks, look at your clothing, make sure that they're all obtained in the right and correct way with which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with. And also, what do we learn from this great hadith? أَنَّ مِنْ أَسْبَابِ قُبُولِ الدُّعَاءِ أَرْبَعَةُ أَشْيَاءِ. There are four things that are means of the dua being accepted. أَحَدُهَا, the first one, السَّفَر. Someone who's in a journey. Because he said in the hadith, ذَكَرَ الرَّجُلُ يُطِيلُ السَّفَر. Someone who's involved in a long journey. So one of the means of somebody's a'mal to be, somebody's dua to be accepted is someone who's involved in a journey. Normally they face difficulties and hardship. They require a lot of patience. And if they make dua, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts it. والثاني إظهار الداعي الذلة والافتقار لمولاه. The second thing that will make your dua to be accepted is to show your humbleness and the need, great need that you have to your creator, from your creator Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to show that you raise your hands to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you are in great need of him, and when you need any help you run to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, وهو ما يفيده قوله أشعث أغبر. أشعث أغبر, he said, this person, although the hair is messy and is full of dust and his clothing, and then he's raising his hand, therefore being humble to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then الثالث رفع اليدين إلى السماء بالدعاء. Raising your hands toward the heavens when you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for dua is one of the means of the dua being accepted. And the fourth one, الرابع الإلحاء على الله بتكرار ذكر ربوبيته. And then when you're calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you should repeat again and again, Ya Rabbi, Ya Allah, Ya Rabbi, Ya Rabbi, Ya Rabbi, to be praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his glory and glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his most beautiful names, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this becomes a means of the dua being accepted. Therefore, my dear brothers, one thing that you should learn from this great hadith, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept the deeds except that which are clean and that which are full of sincerity. And when you do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not doing it to show people off. If you do that, therefore you will be wasting your time. And if your clothes or your food involves any kind of cheating and all that kind of things, therefore will be means for your a'mals not to be accepted, and your deeds will not be accepted, and also your dua not to be accepted. So this great hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is giving us an example, an encouragement for a Muslim to be clean and nice, not to be involved in lying, not to be involved in cheating, not to be involved in deceiving, and not to think that I can cheat and steal and do and obtain money in the wrong way and then pretend that I want to build my Jannah and give it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have been warned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not interested in all that kind of things. Therefore, a Muslim should be clean in their heart, should be clean in their tongue, and the whole body should be clean and clear from that which is haram, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not be happy with. This is what we learn from this great hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What we also learn, that eating halal, aklul halali wa amalus salihati amrullahi biha jami'un nasi al-anbiya' wa ghayrihim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, eating that which is halal and also following the good deeds after eating the halal, it is the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all mankind, starting from prophets, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuha ar-rusulu kulu min at-tayyibati wa'malu saliha. After eating that which is haram, therefore it is very important. Earnings, it is one of greater ibadah. When you're going to work, make sure that your tongues take care of it from lying. Your business dealings with people, make sure that it is free from cheating. You might make money today, but tomorrow you will die and just go with sins. You will never go to your grave with money. You will go with sins. You will be accountable to that. Although the money you leave behind to those who are behind you, your children and others, as a will, and they will use it the way they want, but you are the one who is going to stand alone in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make sure Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said to the believers, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu kulu, who you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, kulu min tayyibati ma razaqnakum, eat the best and the good that we provided for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our provider, therefore let's choose the best of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided to us. And also, aklul halali yu'inu ala amal as-salihat. Eating that which is halal, is showing, the hadith is showing us, will encourage you and will help you to do the good a'mals. If you have stolen, you will be scared to be seen in the masjid. If you have stolen somebody's clothes, you will be scared to be seen wearing it in the masjid. But if you have earned that little bit that is halal and you are wearing and you're standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the tawfiq to follow that with good a'mals. Therefore, eating that which is halal, the little that is halal and blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is blessing, and it can be the means of you to go to Jannah. Then so much that you obtain in the deceiving and wrong way, it can be the means of your destruction, the means of your distress, and the means of depression in this life, and then the means of punishment and ending up in the hellfire, wal-iyadu billah. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, life is very short. Make sure you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your dealings and in your earnings. And also, this great hadith, it teaches us one of the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is to raise the hands when you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in dua. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in the hadith, yamuddu yadayhi ila as-samaa, raising his hands towards the heavens, raise your hands to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa fa'alahu sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself has done that. He's raised his hands when he's raised up his hands when he's asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, one of the sunnah is when you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to repeat again and again, Allahumma, Allahumma, or to say, Ya Rabbi, Ya Rabbi, Ya Rabbi, or to say, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, and then ask what you want from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also this great hadith is teaching us that the Prophet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Kulu, eat min tayyibati, of the goodness, ma razaqnakum, what we have provided for you. We have to have a firm belief that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the provider. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who gives you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all other things are asbab, means just to go and get it, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who gives you. He is the one who feeds you. He is responsible for all that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, what we have to do is thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to us. And also, we learn from this great hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not in need of us or our money that we give. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said in the Quran, وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ, give that we have given it to you. What we have given it to you, give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That which you've earned through your hard work and effort, but you must know when you're putting that effort, it is tawfiq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who's blessing you with the health. Allah is blessing you with the eyes. Allah is blessing you with the energy. Allah is blessing you with life to go and be able to earn that. Don't think it's because you are clever, because of your strength that you're getting all that earnings. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-kasbu al-tayyibu huwa al-kasbu al-halal. The earnings that is beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the earnings that which is halal. Earn little that is halal than earning a lot which is haram, and it could be the means of your destruction, wal-iyadu billah. And we said that when you do the a'mals, we do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you greatly. Because if you do it for a human being, by showing a human being, impressing human beings, just know that they are in desperate need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way you are in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The human being cannot do much for you. Allah is the doer, Allah is the giver, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who does each and everything. Others are asbab, they are just means. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also, in a'mals, doing the deeds when you're doing it, we said sincerity and ikhlas is very important. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَنَا أَغْنَى الْأَغْنِيَاءُ عَنِ الشِّرْكِ, I am rich of those rich people, from I'm not in need of those who give or who do عَنِ الشِّرْكِ, and do things which involve the shirk. So those who give things which involve showing off or riya, or do a'mals which involve showing off or riya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I am completely away and I'm not interested in, I am more than sufficient, I've got more than enough, I am not interested in that kind of things. Man ashraka ma'i ghayri, whoever was to do something to show off to others, and also to do the amal, or to do the deed, showing off others, or to try and impress others, instead of trying to earn the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, taraktuhu wa shirka, I will leave him with his shirk, with his associating, trying, if you're associating others with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will leave you with your shirk, wal-iyadu billah. Inshallah, dear brothers, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this beautiful hadith is teaching us some beautiful manners, beautiful things in earnings in the right way and correct way. The prophets were ordered the same way. Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also ordering us to do the similar things. Therefore, inshallah, we should follow these teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The sahabas, they've spent their life doing these. They would rather be earning very little that is halal to earn the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than eating or earning so much that which involves haram, and then which will, they know that they will live in this dunya and then they will end up in being punished in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us understandings of our deen and understanding of the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when we hear these great things, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the tawfiq to follow these things and bring them in our life, so that our life can be beautiful, so that our life can be the life which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happy with, and end us in Jannah inshaAllah. Wa sallallahu alaihi wasallam Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.